To other national matters, the presidency on Tuesday said that they returned $311 million, which was part of the money allegedly stolen by the late former head of state General Sani Abacha, has been allocated for infrastructure development in the country. A statement issued by the senior special assistant to the president of media and publicity, Garba Shehu, in Abuja, said the funds will be specifically to address decades overdue infrastructure development like the second Niger Bridge, the Lagos-Ibadan and Abuja-Kaduna-Kano expressways, and in the Mambila Power Project. The statement, titled "The Return of the Abacha Stolen Millions from the United States and Jersey," noted that the money and the ones before it was a testament to the growing and deepening relationship between the government of Nigeria and the government of the United States. The presidency, while also noting that part of the loot returned in 2019 was being used for grain grants and free school feeding programs, added that without the current returned loot, the fight against COVID-19 would be even tougher. We have Libros Oshoma, legal practitioner, in the studio with us to discuss about this. Good afternoon, Libros.
Yeah, good afternoon.
Why are you smiling?
Yeah, because the statement from the president is laughable. And sometimes you begin to wonder if these people issuing this statement, you know, what they take Nigerians for. Oh, that if not for this return loot, it would have been tougher. And so, that means, you know, while other countries were preparing, you know, ground for, you know, from December till like about January, February, what were we doing? We just folded our hands and
we thought it won't come to us, maybe.
We knew it would get to us. Mm-hmm. And so say that we thought it would come to us, you know, means that, you know, we're not thinking at all. Mm. And then you give government so much credit for nothing. You know, it was because of the growing relationship and, you know, all of that. Why are we so much in a hurry to latch on to eulogize America? Mm-hmm. You know, we should be asking questions, you know. What led to you even receiving this money in the first place? You know, stolen funds. And meanwhile, a man who receives stolen goods or stolen funds is as guilty as a man who stole the funds. So, you know, that so says the law, universal laws, mm-hmm. you know, especially even the one in our country. And so, but when we now begin to praise people for returning, you know, stolen funds that they were housed for long, even without interest, and then cause to question, you know, our mentality in the first place. So that's why I was laughing.
All right, let's go to this stolen returned loot. The SGF got a lot of criticism recently for calling it federal assets. What's your thought on that? You know,
if you're calling Abacha's assets.
No, yes, Abacha's asset rather. So how is it?
Maybe he's referring to it as asset recovery. But when people also talk about asset recovery, an asset recovered does not mean that it belongs to the man who stole it. Mm-hmm. You know, it's like you recovering your assets, that, oh, federal government asset that were recovered. I expected him to say, oh, recovered government asset instead of Abacha's asset. And mm-hmm. also, it also goes to show the mentality of people who are leading us. If you describe this loot as Abacha's assets, you know, so that means it wasn't a loot in the first place.
Yeah, probably is offering the country some. He's been generous.
Exactly. So that's why a lot of people are saying that Abacha now is an ancestor who sends us money, you know,
from
the grave anytime we need money. And then also shows that truly we don't have a saving culture, whatever government says. And so then now they are saying, if not for this loot recovered, that we'll probably, you know, the fights. And even though we are not seeing any fights against that COVID-19, would have been, you know,
tougher.
Exactly. So when you now begin to describe your asset that was stolen from you as the man who stole his asset, it calls to mind the mentality of, you know, those that are leading us. And then one big question I've meant to ask most times is, now we talk about Abacha loot. We know that Abacha, throughout his years as head of state, was one of those head of state that didn't travel out of this Nigeria. So people helped Abacha to move this loot. Who helped Abacha to move this money? We're not talking about those people, because they're equally as guilty. How much did they make from moving these funds, right from starting from Obasanjo's days, who have been recovering money? And then even though it's really not known how much Abacha looted, mm-hmm. but Transparency International had you know, estimated it to about $5 billion. You know, so when you put all of this together, the next question is, who helped Abacha loot this money, you know, from, you know, the coffers of government? Mm-hmm. And where are the people? How much of such funds have been recovered from them? And then what is happening now? Because Abacha is dead, so it is easy for us to refer to him. Mm-hmm. How about those that are alive now?
And probably still looting someone.
About those that looted before him and those that are still looting. As we speak now, we're recovering so much. What we talked about so much that Desiani looted. But yet, we keep playing ping pong with, you know, Desiani's allegations to recover loot. And nobody's even talking about the former president. Right. It's as if, you know, he didn't steal a cup, even though people around him stole. And so when you have that kind of mindset, you know, it becomes very difficult for you, for people to truly, genuinely believe that indeed you want to fight corruption. Mm. And then look at it from the flip side also. We also know that there are so many people in government today who are there because of what they can gain. You remember right. the 500 million MTN and the federal government's bribe scandal, okay. Abba Kyari was named. You remember also under Obasanjo, the Siemens scandal, how much people made, you know, what happened to it, even though all of those involved in Germany and other countries have been, you know, jailed and served jail terms. How about now we're even going back to the same semen. Mm-hmm. Abba Kyari is gone now. What happens to all of those allegations that his name was mentioned?
Hopefully they won't be swept under the carpet.
Exactly. So that's why for me, I think that's why a lot of people are saying that this issue of the return loot, now you've called it assets, mm-hmm. that we should ensure that it is not relooted. And those are part of the things why I was laughing.
Well, and they get into the right places, the projects for which.
Yeah, because what government, I think what government should do now, so that it doesn't look as if we just criticize that we really don't have, you know, a way forward. Because these funds were looted and you have recovered them and repatriated them back, mm-hmm. what government, the only way they can truly win the trust of the people is to ensure that, not just say, oh, this money will be plowed back into infrastructural development, is to ensure proper monitoring,
right.
you know, transparency in spending the funds. Mm-hmm. The former ones that were recovered, they said they shared it, you know, among market women and then for homegrown feeding school, feeding program.
Yeah.
And then I wonder how many of these public schools, you know, actually saw those foods. And I also wonder how many of those market women received those 10,000 naira that they were talking about. So all of this, there are still allegations that some of these funds were used for election. Until date, those areas have been swept under the carpet. Nobody's mm-hmm. investigating. And so when you now say you want to spend on rails and the second Niger Bridge, you know, you're simply just going to raise suspicion. And the only way we can truly speak truth, you know, to ourselves is to ensure that there's proper utilization and transparency as the money is allocated.
Mm-hmm.
You know, you say, oh, this is the money that from that Abacha loot we have allocated money for second Niger Bridge. And this money should be able to take us from this point C to point F, and everybody can actually monitor. Mm-hmm. And then some people have also asked, what's happened to the fund budgeted for those projects before? You know, so all of these questions are hanging in the balance, and until mm-hmm. we answer them, we can't truly win the trust of the people.
Thank you so very much, Liberal Soshoma, for your thoughts there.
Always my pleasure.